Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a fun, creative Facebook cover picture as one of many Polaroid snapshots of your favorite memories. The Photoshop template that I provided to you gives you the flexibility to add, replace, and reposition your photos as often as you like. The template is located in my video's description or project files. The top layer is a preview overlay, which allows you to see how your cover photo art and profile picture will look on your Facebook page. The gray layer cover photo here will be replaced with a background image that you'll ultimately place your Polaroid snapshots onto. The profile picture layer will be where you place your profile photo into, and the layers below it will be where you place your meaningful photos. Remember, you can add and/or relocate these Polaroids anywhere on your background. Click the thumbnail of the cover photo here layer to make it active. If you're working on version CC or later, I'll show you the next step in a minute. If you're working on a version earlier than CC, find and open an image that you'd like to use for your background. To place it into the Facebook template, press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open the template document and press Ctrl or Command V to paste it into it. To resize and reposition it, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. Then drag it to a location you like and press Enter or Return. Merge your background image layer with the layer below it by pressing Ctrl or Command E. If you're working on version CC or later, to replace the gray background with your photo, go to File and place Embedded. Find your image, click it, and click Place. Resize and reposition it, then merge it with the bottom layer. Open the Profile Picture folder and click the top layer to make it active. Open a photo that you'd like to use for your profile picture using the steps that I showed you earlier for the version of Photoshop you're using. Click the chain link icon to unlink the layer mask and the layer next to it. Drag the layer mask next to your profile photo. Make the layer below it active. We'll trash or delete it since we don't need it anymore. To do this, if you're working on a version of Photoshop earlier than CS4, drag it to the trash can. If you're working on CS4 or later, just press the delete key on your keyboard. Make your profile picture layer active, open your Transform tool, and drag it over the area of the template where you want it placed. To angle the image, go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. Finesse its size and location, and press Enter or Return to accept it. Close the folder, and open the Polaroid 3 folder. Make the top layer active. Open an image you'd like to place into the top left Polaroid snapshot. As before, unlink the layer mask, drag it next to your image, make the layer below it active, and either trash or delete it. Make your image layer active, and open your Transform tool. Drag it into the Polaroid template, rotate it, resize it, and position it until you're happy with its angle, size, and location. Then press Enter or Return. If you want to adjust the location and angle of the entire Polaroid, including its white frame, I'll show you how to do that after we've placed all of our images into the other Polaroid templates. Using the exact steps as you use for the top left Polaroid, place your other images into the rest of the Polaroid templates. To reposition and/or angle your Polaroids, first make sure that Auto Select is not checked. Click back the chain link icon to link the layer and the layer mask. Then collapse the folder. Now you can reposition the Polaroid and angle it by using your transform tool. To reposition and/or angle another Polaroid, open its folder, activate the chain link, close the folder, and make the layer active. Repeat these steps for the remaining Polaroids. Next, we'll save our profile picture and cover photo so we can upload them to our Facebook page. Click off the eyeball icon next to Preview Overlay to hide it. Make the profile picture layer active and make a composite snapshot of your visible image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Open your Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control-click or Command-click the Cover Photo Crop channel to make a selection of its shape. Go to Image and Crop. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command-D. We're going to save it as a Save for Web image. If you're working on a version earlier than CC 2015, go to File and Save for Web. However, if you're working on version CC 2015 or later, go to File, Export, and Save for Web Legacy, which opens the Save for Web window. Save it as a JPEG with a high compression. Optimized should be checked, and make sure Convert to sRGB is also checked. sRGB is pretty much the default color space everywhere you look. Most browsers, applications, and devices are designed to work with sRGB. Click Save. Save it to your desktop and name it Facebook Cover Art. Then click Save. Open your History panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and History. Click Load Selection, which is just above Crop. This reverts your document to the time just before you cropped it. Control-click or Command-click the Profile Picture Crop channel to make a selection of its shape. Go to Image and Crop. Save it the same way you did for your cover photo art. The Save for Web window remembers the settings from the last time, so just click Save. Name it Facebook Profile Picture and click Save. As before, in the History panel, click Load Selection just above Crop. Open your browser and your Facebook page. Click Add Cover Photo. If you see this message, click OK. Click Upload Photo and find your Facebook cover photo file. Click it and click Open. There's no need to reposition it because the template I provided is perfectly sized for Facebook, at least for the time being. Click Save Changes. Click Update Profile Picture and click Upload Photo. Find and open your Facebook profile picture. And click Save. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.